612, Information Technology and Business Computing. And in the previous video, you watched the overview of the course, the course objectives, the outline, the assessment, and many parts of the course. And now we are going to start with the first lecture on the Information Technology and Business Computing. And this the first topic is on computer hardware, and we'll be taking on the first lecture, the first part of the lecture, that deals with the computer introduction and the different parts of a computer. So in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the meaning of a computer, what a computer is, what it does, and what are the functions of a computer. And we're also going to identify the different major parts of a computer, the components, the input parts, the processor, the output, the storage, and the memory. We also go to discuss about the way you can be able to store information in the computer system, either on primary memory or on secondary memory storage. And then we discuss or distinguish the input devices and output devices based on the different technologies and their uses in the different areas. So we start with the meaning of a computer. A computer is actually an electronic device that has four important functions. And the first place, you have the acception or to accept information and data that is put from the user to the computer. So it accepts data that are coming from the user to the computer. And then it stores information or data that has been processed from the processor. And then, of course, there is a processing unit which manipulates the data according to the user that is being put. And then there is the output section or output area where the user receives the output from the processor, either on a printer or on a screen. So let us look into the block diagram of a computer and see the different sections of a computer as shown here. So a computer normally has five important blocks. So the first block of a computer is actually the input block. So you have the input, then you have the processing part, so which is the CPU, then you have the output part. So you have the output part. Then again here you have the storage, which is actually the memory in this case. And then down here you have the storage, which gives you the way you can be to store information. You can be able to store your information, so the storage. So these are the five important blocks of a computer system. So a computer, any computer system has these important five functions. So in the first place, we are going to discuss on the input part. The input is where the user inputs the data to the computer to be processed. So the user will be here inputting data to a computer, and therefore they be an arrow all the way going into the one direction to the processor to process that information. When the processor is processing information, it has to work in line with the memory to make sure that all the information that you're accessing can be accessed easily from the computer. So the CPU sometimes has to fetch information from the memory, which is RAM. And at the same time, whenever we need to fetch information from the memory to the processor, there must be another arrow coming down, showing you that there is a two-way movement of information from either from the CPU to the memory or memory to the CPU. Likewise, whenever the processor is working, it needs to store information. The information can be stored on storage devices, this is an arrow, from the processor to the storage. But again, at the same time, you can have saved your information or data on your computer system. Then you want to continue working with the data that you saved on the storage devices. In this case, there will be another arrow that is coming from the storage all the way to the processor to fetch and start working on that particular area. But again, whenever the processor has done its work, it gives out the output, so there is an arrow coming from the processor all the way to the output section to give you the output in different forms. So now, let us discuss on how we can be able to get the information in the computer that has been processed. So in the first place, we discuss on the input section. On the input section, we have different components here, which would be either the mouse or the keyboard. Then again, on storage, you can be able to store information and data on many storage devices, including the CD or DVD, or it could be hard disk. It could be memory, magnetic storage. It could be floppy. It could be flash. It could be memory card. So these are the different storage devices that can be able to store your information from the processor or the other device. But again here, when the processor is working, it works in line with memory. In this case, the memory is the RAM, random access memory, to make sure that the information can be easily accessed whenever the processor is in need of that information. But then, when the processor has finished processing the information, and then it gives the output in either from a display or monitor, from the display or monitor to show you the digital form of it, or it could be either from the printer to get the output printed material or printed output throughout the printer. So basically, this is the block diagram of a computer, having important five blocks: input block, CPU block, storage block, memory block, and the output block. Thank you very much, and have time to do your exercises.